Hello friends, welcome to Solutions of Introduction to Algorithms Chapter 1. Today we will see question number 2 and 3 of Introduction to Algorithms Chapter 1. Let's see question number 2. Other than speed, what other measures of efficiency might one use in a real world setting? So other than speed, what other measures of efficiency can be used? This is a very general question. You can think of any other measures and comment below. I am taking few examples. For example, memory usage of the PC can be one of the measures of the efficiency, power consumption, etc. So this is a very general question. Let's go to the next question. Question number 3 says, select a data structure that you have seen previously and discuss its strengths and limitations. So here I am taking the example of linked list. You can discuss about your own data structure and comment below. So in linked list, what are the advantages? The first advantage is that unlike array, there is no need to define an initial size for a linked list, because linked list is a dynamic data structure. Here you can allocate and deallocate space and memory to add nodes and remove nodes while the program is running. But in array, you have to define the fixed size of the array before the program starts. Another advantage can be linked list are dynamic data structure which can grow and shrink, allocating and deallocating memory while the program is running. As I have said before, that we can allocate and deallocate space because this is a dynamic data structure, and add nodes and remove nodes. So this is a very good advantage over array, because array has the limitation that you have to define the size before. Generally, we use the malloc command in C. So these are the general advantages of linked list. Now let's see some of the disadvantages. So what are the disadvantages of linked list? They use more memory than arrays because of the storage used by their pointers. Now, as we know that linked list use pointers to point to the next node. This is because the next node of the linked list can be present in any of the address spaces, because while you are allocating a space in memory, the address given to the space can be anywhere in the memory. So the next node can be present in any part of the memory. Because of that, we use pointers to point to the next node so that we can go to that address and access the next node. But in arrays, what we do, we allocate the memories one after the other, so the next element will be present in the next address location. So this is one disadvantage of linked list over arrays. Another one is that nodes in a linked list must be read in order from the beginning, as linked lists are inherently sequential access. Now we know that arrays are random access and linked lists are sequential access. Random access means if we want to go to a particular index in an array, we can do it in constant time. We can directly go to that element by accessing its index. But here in linked list, we don't know the exact indexes or the address locations of the nodes present in the linked list. To access a node, we have to start from the beginning and traverse the whole linked list to go to that particular node. So this is another disadvantage of linked list. And for this question, you can think of any other data structure and comment below. Hope you like this video. In the next lecture, I will do rest of the questions of Introduction to Algorithms. Till then, happy learning. Thank you.